Hello dear students, this is teacher Nilambari and today we will learn about disaster management. In today's session, we will learn about various types of disasters, the casualties taking place because of disaster, action taken towards disaster management, basic principles of first aid, transportation of victim or patient, and other emergency measures. So let's begin with the lesson. Can you recall, question 1, which natural calamities have you experienced? How did they affect the conditions in your surroundings? Answer: In July 2005, heavy rains caused flooding in many parts of Maharashtra, including large areas of Mumbai. In the calamity, many people and livestock lost their lives. Local trains, auto rickshaws, taxis, buses, trucks, private vehicles, and buildings were damaged. Roads were submerged and there was severe water clogging in most parts. Hospitals were damaged. The city incurred huge financial losses. Dear students, you can write your own experience of natural calamity you faced. Question number 2. How will you make a plan to be safe from calamities or to minimize the damage? As a responsible citizen, we can contribute to minimizing the occurrence of natural calamities like floods by taking measures to reduce land pollution, by properly disposing waste material or recycling them, increasing plantations, proper town planning, proper road construction and infrastructure can help prevent floods. We can plan to be safe from calamities in regions that are prone to frequent natural disasters by keeping the following things handy as part of disaster management, such as torchlight, first aid kit, ample food supply, water storage, emergency number list, extra pair of clothes, etc. Educating people about the precautions to be taken when such calamities occurs. Thus, by taking appropriate measures, we can draw a plan to be safe from calamities and minimize the damage. Natural and man-made disasters. These are two types of disasters, natural and man-made disasters. Various natural disasters. Now you know very well the various natural disasters like thunderbolts or lightning, floods, fire, and man-made disasters like accidents, bomb explosions, chemical accidents in industries, stampedes in mass gatherings, riots, etc. occur around us time to time. They cause large-scale damage to life and property. Can you tell what are the type of casualties that are seen to occur in different types of disasters? Now following are the different types of casualties which are been listed in the table. Okay, so let's find out what are they. Disaster type, flood. The casualties which we come across during flood is loss of life and property, loss of cattle, people affected by various waterborne diseases. Now, if there is earthquake, what will happen? Loss of life and property, fire related casualty, injured casualties due to collapsing walls, flying glass, falling object, etc. Now, if there is a famine, then what will be the casualties? People will get affected by malnutrition, they will not get the food, starvation, epidemics, etc. Disaster management is action implemented through proper planning. So, when we say disaster management, it requires a proper planning, organized activity and coordination. Now what it includes? It includes the following things: prevention of losses and danger, improving tolerance, providing relief from disaster, minimizing the intensity and extent of harm, preparation to face the disaster, immediate action in the disaster situation, assessment of damages and intensity of the disaster. Once the disaster takes place, you need to assess how much damage took place and what was the intensity of the disaster, how severe was the disaster. Arranging for rescue work and help. You need to rescue people and help people. Rehabilitation and rebuilding. Now, people who suffered because of these disasters, they need to rehabilitate. Okay. Basic principles of first aid. Life and resuscitation. ABC method. ABC, that is A stands for airway, B for breathing and C for circulation. Now let's find out what is this method. Okay, airway. If the victim has difficulty breathing, the head should be held in a backward sloping position or the chin should be raised so that the respiratory passage remains open. You can see over here how it has been shown. Okay, breathing. If breathing has stopped, the victim should be given artificial ventilation by mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Circulation. This is the third method. If the victim is unconscious, then after giving mouth-to-mouth respiration twice, the heart should be pressed down hard by pressing the chest with both the palms. These two actions should be repeated alternately about 15 times. This is called cardiopulmonary resuscitation, or we can say CPR. It helps to bring the circulation back to normal. Then there are some more methods, like if it is bleeding, then what can be done? If the victim is injured and bleeding through the wound, then the wound should be covered with an antiseptic pad and pressure applied on it for 5 minutes with either thumb or palm. Now, if the victim has got any fracture, then what can be done? Fracture and impact on vertebrae. If any bone is fractured, it is essential that the fractured part be immobilized. That means we should not move that part. It can be done with the help of any available wooden rods, batons or rulers. If there is an impact on the back or vertebral column, the patient should be kept immobile on a firm stretcher. Now, if the victim got burnt, then what we can do? Burns. If victims have burn injuries, it is beneficial to hold the injured part under clean and cold flowing water for at least 10 minutes. Now, there are certain other injuries. For injuries like sprains, twisting and contusion, then the RICE remedy should be applied. Now, what is RICE remedy? R stands for rest, I for ice, C for compression and E for elevate. Rest. Allow the victim to sit in a relaxed position. Apply an ice pack to the injured part. After the ice pack treatment, the injured part should be massaged gently and then elevate. The injured part should be kept in a raised or elevated position. Now, these are the various methods to transport the victims, okay, or the patients. This is the first method, that is cradle method. It is useful for children and underweight victims, okay. Then second method is carrying on four-hand chair. This is useful when support is needed for the part below the waist. Okay, so by this method we can carry the victim. The third method is pulling or lifting method. This is used for carrying an unconscious patient through a short distance. Now there is one more method which is shown over here, that is carrying on two-hand chair, useful for those patients who cannot use their hands but can hold their body upright. Okay. Then is human crutch method. If one of the leg is injured, the victim should be supported with minimum load on the other leg. Right. Now, the next method is carrying piggy bank, useful for carrying patients who are unconscious. Okay, so the patient who is unconscious, we can carry them on our back. Then a stretcher. In an emergency, if a conventional stretcher is not available, then a temporary stretcher can be made using bamboos, blanket, etc. Okay. Now, other emergency measures. Like boats are used by the civil administration to rescue people trapped in a flooded area. Then, as an emergency measure, wooden boats, bamboo floats, air-filled tube from a tire can be used. A fire extinguisher is a portable appliance that can be easily carried anywhere. So, if there is a fire, then we should have a fire extinguisher with us. Okay. Various appliances are used to put out a fire. Right. So, with this, the lesson gets over. Thank you.